I want you to start the show off with the way you start off your Instagram videos.
Okay.
Get people woke up.
Out that bed. Get up out that bed. Baby, it's time to get the day started. It's time to wake up and be inspired.
Get up out
the
bed.
And also, with this motivation, right, that you have it within, too, you are killing it in terms of the brand deals that you have. Talk about just being in this mode of life where you're essentially realizing your dream.
Oh, my God. Are we about to start crying? I'm really just so grateful. It's been a long journey transitioning from TV to being a full-time entrepreneur and content creator, just getting amazing opportunities to showcase who I am with all the love and support that I get from the DMV. It just makes me so elated, and I'm just grateful that everybody supports me and loves me the way they do.
Like attracts like. You put that energy out there, and that's why it comes back to you tenfold.
Listen, so that's why we all like each other and stuff.
I think it's gotta
be.
Birds of a feather
flock together.
Okay.
Frank, we are just so proud of you.
Thank you.
Make us so happy to see you on social media. And so we're just happy to have you with us. So you know what that means. It's time to get into it.
We got to get your take on several stories. Yeah. First up, we're getting a new look at Wendy Williams thanks to an upcoming documentary on Lifetime. Producer Chris, we've been wondering about Wendy, and now a lot of people are concerned.
Had this conversation in the newsroom about we hadn't heard anything about or from Wendy Williams in a long while, and that changed last night with this first trailer for this documentary. It's called Where Is Wendy Williams, and it gets pretty raw. The former talk show host tells her side of the story. After being placed under a guardianship, Wendy's son and sisters are featured in the documentary as they battle Wendy's guardians over her health. Take a look.
I have no money, and I'm gonna tell you something. If it happens to me, it could happen to you.
As her family, we were all sitting on the sidelines watching, and she was crying out for help.
Did you drink this whole thing today?
Keep it there.
Okay.
Keep it there.
My mom, she always talks about how she wants to work, but I feel as though she's worked enough.
She has people around who are yes people and allowing this to continue.
This is all too much. Go!
So some of our worst fears confirmed from that first trailer. The two-part series airs February 24th and 25th on Lifetime, guys.
First impression, Frank.
That's heavy.
Yeah.
I feel very heavy seeing that.
Yeah.
Just knowing who she has been, regardless of if people like her or not, I think just knowing her story and her propelling into all the great things she was able to do in her career to motivate me to even sit here and want to do something like this, I think to see her like that, that's sad.
Yeah. Mm. You know, she was the multi-hyphenate media person before we had a name for
yes.
it, really, and really knocked down the doors, television, radio, and the like. My thing is, I've been wondering about Wendy, especially when we sit here and talk about celebrity dish stories, and I go, wow, I wonder what Wendy would have said about Nicki Minaj and Megan Thee Stallion or the Color Purple.
She would have had a time with all the things.
We miss her voice, but I just hope that she gets well.
Yeah.
I do.
Yeah, you can only wish for the best for her, but I'm also thinking about just how quickly it all happened.
Mm.
Right, we saw her in the limelight, and then that fall happened, and then it just quickly tumbled down so quickly. I just wish that people would acknowledge the fact that she is a legend.
Yes.
Right? And as much as she's gone through many different iterations of her health and her career, we saw her at her highest point.
Right.
And she was able to exist in that. I'm not sure how people are going to be able to receive her in this particular film, seeing her at such a low point.
Yeah.
Just watching it, like you said, it was crushing to watch.
Yeah, it was very
heavy. But I think also, Chris, and I don't know if you would agree, maybe it will soften some people up to Wendy so they can see the behind the scenes of her struggle and know that, okay, she had a lot of issues, multiple issues happening at once. Let's give her a little break.
While still dealing with the
fame. Exactly.
Yeah. I think definitely getting a better team behind her, because that seems to be something that keeps coming up, is her team. And you are only as strong as the people that are supporting you. So
that's right.
I'm sending Wendy all the love.
All the love, all the good energy. Chris. Yeah.
Hopefully it has a happy ending. Guys, let's talk about Justin Timberlake and Britney Spears now, but I need to start by taking you back. Remember, Britney recently apologized for her memoir and anyone she may have offended. She also heaped some praise on her ex, Justin Timberlake, and his new song, Selfish. Then Justin Timberlake goes and performs a one-night-only concert in New York City. He starts the song Cry Me a River, which is famously about his ex, with the words, I apologize to absolutely bleeping nobody. Well, Britney Spears has now retracted her apology. She went on Instagram last night, posted a message saying that she heard someone was talking smack about her. I'll just say that. She used a different four-letter word. She said she takes her apology back. She said, are you going to have to go crying home to your mom again, just like last time? Now, while all this is going on, Justin Timberlake is apparently seething behind the scenes that all of this drama has overshadowed the release of his new album and his new music, which it seems like to us, we talked about yesterday, he brought upon himself.
Yeah.
Now, the background of all of this, too, is that non-apology from Justin Timberlake also happened to fall on the 20th anniversary of his situation, let's just call it that, with Janet Jackson. Remember that Super Bowl halftime show?
Can't forget that.
February 4th, 2004. So now that non-apology looks like it's directed at not only Britney Spears, but Janet Jackson, and fans of both are furious with him, Marissa.
He needs to make a new song called Cry Me Some Vitriol.
Okay.
Because that's what I'm getting. It's not even about the river anymore.
No. How can he be surprised?
This is all, I'm convinced, calculated and planned, but it's not doing what he...
But calculated wrong.
It's not doing what he thought it was going to do.
Yeah, I keep saying this. I've said this from the very beginning. This has all been calculated. My only challenge with this is that they've given Justin a platform to do this. Britney has got to be triggered by this. Out of all the things she's gone through, she's got to be triggered by this man saying, listen, I'm not sorry.
Yeah.
And I don't know why he keeps using this platform to push out more negative energy towards Britney. It seems a bit cheap, and it also doesn't seem to be a good fit for him in
this
current
moment. That's what I was about
to say. It's not a good fit.
Regardless of how you feel about him and this whole Britney situation, he is extremely talented.
Right.
JT can dance, he can sing, he can act.
We've never
seen
him.
He does not need this publicity.
That's what I call lazy marketing. You thought that you were going to maximize off social media and have a scandal, which is popular these days. People have a scandal, and then they want to drop some music, or they want to drop their book. But everybody doesn't need to do that. You are talented. You could have just did what you needed to do without all the extra, because taking apologies away and all that, what?
And not only that, Janet Jackson said in her documentary that came out a couple of years ago, she's not even waiting or missing an apology from Justin.
Right.
So please keep her name out of your mouth.
I don't want an apology from somebody that pulled my... on TV either.
Yeah, she didn't do that to herself.
Right.
Yeah. Beef sells. I mean, just ask Cardi B and Offset. I mean, they...
Ask Megan Thee Stallion.
It sells, but I think this is just distasteful.
Yeah, I think because it's coming from him. I didn't expect that from him. I think it's very off-putting.
Yeah, it was all water on the bridge, and then he brought it back up again.
Yeah. Too much credit.
Well, thank you for at least giving us some inspiration off the top. We appreciate it.
You know, you gotta have balance.
You do.
Send them off. Send them off. Tell them what they need to do.
Keep shining, Frank.
Y'all gotta get up out of that bed, okay, and keep watching, all right?
And be good when you get out of the bed.
Okay, and stop laying on being tired. We got things to do. I done worked out and everything before I came down here this morning.
That's right.
Thanks for coming, and take care. We'll see you soon.
Thank you.
All right, 10:30.